I ended up in this by being in a disaster. It's quite remarkable how many of us in this field were in a disaster, and that stimulated our interest in it. In fact, I can actually chart the moment when I became interested in this to the nearest 1/10 of a second, thanks to instrumental seismology, because it was an earthquake. Well, it was southern Italy, 1980. I caught a train at 7 o'clock on the evening of the 23rd of November, and at 7:34 and 52.8 seconds, the earthquake started. I thought the train had been hit by a bomb. It hadn't, of course. It didn't derail, although it's the only time I've ever been on a train that's travelled sideways. We stopped at Pompeii Station. That's modern Pompeii, nothing much to do with the archaeological investigations. Pitch darkness, aftershocks, fear, partial collapses of buildings. And that was the start of a long odyssey that has gone on for 33 years so far. In an earthquake, in a matter of seconds, you can have mass destruction, hundreds of thousands of people left homeless, large numbers of casualties, dead and injured, in a major earthquake at least. Theory helps us to make sense out of chaotic situations, out of high levels of complexity, and we need to do that in order to understand the phenomenon of disaster. In fact, there's a lot of common ground between one disaster and another, and particularly in the way that human beings react to disaster. Disaster is not a natural phenomenon, it's a human phenomenon. It's the way human society puts itself at risk that is responsible for disaster. Never mind the earthquakes or eruptions or floods as physical phenomena, they are merely the triggers. What really matters is what people do. The great tragedy of the world as it is that it's spent all its money on recovering from and responding to disasters. It has not spent a significant amount or enough money on preventing disaster, mitigating the effects of it, and becoming resilient. We've known about this for decades or even possibly centuries. Why haven't we really done it? One reason is we cannot afford not to react to disasters when they do occur. Another reason is we often feel we can save money by not preparing, and there are plenty of excuses that politicians and public administrators and others can give for not reacting. But to be a more mature global society, we've got to act now to prevent and reduce disasters. There are plenty of worldwide initiatives, and these are about to be renewed at the United Nations level. So, making a transition from reacting to what is sometimes called proactive approaches is certainly one thing. Transparency and the guarantee of rights is a most important thing. Where human rights are well understood and guaranteed, then people know what their rights are. We all have rights and responsibilities, but it's rather hard to assume responsibilities properly when we don't have the rights problem sorted out. So giving people human rights, establishing a more democratic society is part and parcel of disaster risk reduction. We need to be more professional about preventing disaster. We need to plan better. We need to have more standard methodologies. We need to have more training. We need to involve citizens. So one very important thing is to ensure that the planning is good and the preparedness. Another very important thing is to involve the citizen. That is to say, the problem of disaster risk is simply too large to leave it to the experts or the authorities, or indeed both. The citizen is going to have to assume responsibility for reducing disaster risk. It's not something that you, as Joe Citizen, can wash your hands of, because you are the risk taker, either in an involuntary way or because you deliberately decide you want to take that risk. You must therefore bear some of the consequences of that. We need to do much risk reduction socially and some of it individually, but we all of us need to understand that risk reduction is our responsibility if we are to live safely. It's no use accusing the government or the experts or the Civil Protection Service of not doing enough when we ourselves have done nothing. So whatever society we live in and whatever hazards we are faced with, then I think we all need to be more involved in the process of reducing them. It is difficult as an argument to get across when we've had many years without a disaster, but then along one comes and the whole business is suddenly top of the agenda for a while. We need it to be a little closer to the top of the agenda in other times.